We know this island has a history of paranormal activity, but since we can't talk to the trapper, we'll need the eyewitness account of Jeremy McCaa, who saw something he couldn't explain out here while filming an episode of Naked and Afraid.
Hey, Jeremy.
Hey, brother.
Nice to meet you.
This is Sarah, the psychic medium that I was telling you about.
How you doing,
Sarah? Very nice to meet you.
I hear you experienced something pretty disturbing out on Kamikaze Island. Can you tell us about it?
That was different.
Yeah.
Me and my partner was out there. We felt like something was out there watching us. And it was almost a nightly thing that you would hear it, but you wouldn't see it. You'd hear it circling around. I can't remember exactly what day, but it was towards the end of our show. We were sitting there talking. We had our diary cams on. I started hearing what sounded like walking. Spun the cameras around, and then we got it.
Do you have that footage here?
I've got the footage.
Can we see that?
Yeah. This was the actual footage.
No. Okay.
There's something walking over there.
Oh my God, that is a face.
Wow.
And do you see that?
The footage that Jeremy McCaa captured while filming Naked and Afraid on Kamikaze Island shows what appears to be a very creepy face staring at them through the trees. But it doesn't seem to match the trapper's account of seeing two mysterious men burying something along the shoreline.
Yeah.
I see clearly two eyes, nose, and a mouth.
That almost looks demonic.
Look at it, man.
You know, everybody keeps asking me, what is it? What is it? What'd you see? What'd you see? Was it a person out there? It was not a person out there. I've got some friends, they'll question it, you know, and they think some of this stuff's made up. I wouldn't normally believe in stuff like that until you actually witness something that you can't explain. You know when a human's sitting there looking at you.
Right.
This was not.
Right. Have you noticed that it's, like, starting to affect you?
I had some time there. I was drinking a good bit.
Yeah.
You kind of want closure, or at least try to figure out what it is.
You just want an answer.
Is that true? I'd love to get an answer.
Yeah. Do you mind if I just for a minute come behind you, and do I have permission to put my hands on your shoulders?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Thank you.
You need me to stand up?
Nope. You're perfect right where you're at. When I touch someone, I immediately get information. You may feel heat as I'm doing this, and I'm just going to go ahead and scan your chakras one by one. Taking a peek. The chakras are access points into the body. I am able to connect the emotions and the imagery that is in his mind. Oh man, it's brought fear in everywhere. This feeling is lost, confused, frustration, exhaustion, pure exhaustion. I see you in your room at night. I see you're awake. And you keep reaching for something on your nightstand. I don't know if you're taking medication to help you sleep.
I take sleeping pills.
Okay.
You have the night terrors. You don't sleep well at night. I mean, you still have the thoughts in your head and stuff that you can't explain.
As I'm moving through, there's a lot of confusion, but it's almost like everything has a hint of fear. So, it feels like something's still with you. Did you take something from the island?
Everything I took, I either ate it or burned it.
Everything?
I do have one thing that I kept.
What is it?
And a walking stick.
Did you ask permission to take it?
Mm-mm. No, I just took it.
I'm worried, Ben. I just want to say this out loud. We might want to take that back. That might need to go back to the island. I think when Jeremy McCaa took that walking stick, he made the spirit or spirits very angry. And I think some sort of negative attachment might have latched onto him. It's really loud to me. Like, I'm being told very loudly from my guides that there's a tie here that we need to look at. I'm wondering if you might be willing to come out with us, maybe bring the walking stick, and even going back out and asking permission if it's okay to take it. In order for Jeremy to get his life back, we're gonna have to work with these energies out on the island to figure out how we're gonna remove this attachment, if we can remove this attachment.
I'd be willing to go out there.
Yeah?
I'd like to kind of put this baby to rest right here.
Oh, I don't blame you.
So.
We were hoping Jeremy McCaa's story would help us figure out what the trapper saw, but it seems like Jeremy is the one who actually needs our help.
This is the same spot where McCaa's original campsite was. It's mostly underwater because of the high tides, but we need to communicate with this thing and figure out what it wants and how to break its attachment with Jeremy.
Sure, anybody anything here that wants to communicate with me? Nothing.
Hey, team.
Do you copy?
Tambo. Ask if it's the crewman.
Were you one of the crewmen of John Lafitte's ship? Were you one that guarded his goal? Holy
The REM pod's going off.
When I ask you a question, I'm gonna start counting. I wanna know how many spirits are here that was involved with John Lafitte?
I'm gonna count. When I get to the right number,
I want you to do the same thing you just did. One.
Hello?
Two.
That is a direct, intelligent response.
If you recognize Jeremy, I want you to make this go off. Holy
This could be the entity that attached itself to Jeremy McCaa.
I'm just gonna lay out some different protection crystals. You've been courted to something here.
She has some of the crystals and some things that she's using to energetically change his environment and change his life for him.
When these energies attach, it's like a fishing hook. It hooks into you and then has a line. And it doesn't matter where you go, man. You could go anywhere and it's still got a hold on you. You can go all the way home, go ahead. Because it's still got a direct line to you, right? And if you try to move too far, it can affect you. Depression, anxiety, insomnia.
All of which I've had.
So I think it's important, if you don't mind, may I touch your shoulders again?
Sarah is trying to physically remove this entity that has latched on to Jeremy McCaa. And I want to find out if it's gone or not by using this 3D camera, which bounces infrared beams off of everything in the frame and maps out people and spirits as stick figures.
It's running all the way up into here on your stomach. We're just going to go ahead. There we go. There we go. There we go.
Holy. There it is.
There we go. 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 There we go.
Our 3D mapping device has detected some kind of anomaly that's appearing as a stick figure.
We are cutting the cord in all timelines and all directions.
Yep, we got one.
There we go, there we go, there we go, there we go.
Because Sarah and Jeremy are pretty much standing on top of each other, the software tracks them as a single stick figure. And even though we can't see it with the naked eye, this anomaly is standing several feet away from where they are.
Your energy is no longer allowed to be connected to Jeremy.
You got this, you got this.
It's right by Sarah. It's right on the side of him.
Keep going, go, 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 go. You're fine.
It is stuck on him.
Yeah, I got it.
There you go, you just popped his arm back. His arm's back now.
Okay, it's moving to your leg. I'm gonna move over. Here we go. Guys, we're just gonna move it some more.
And now it just disappeared. There he goes, he just popped up. Okay. He's right on the leg.
Yeah, wants to reattach, son of a...
And it's getting bigger.
You need to release Jeremy and do so now. It's just upset, I'm just gonna keep pulling. I'm just gonna keep pulling.
There you go.
Oh.
It's leaving. It's detached.